Okay, so a bit more about stress strain curves and material properties. You can have a material that is very linear in its behavior, very hooking in its behavior. And then when it comes to failing, it just goes bang like that. And that is characteristic of a very brittle material. So here we have not reached a hooking limit. We haven't reached a yield point. We've just had hooking behavior up to the point of failure. And the point of failure here is called the ultimate tensile stress. This is very characteristic of brittle materials like glass, for example. You won't normally see it with wood. You might see it with thermally modified wood, because thermally modified wood is quite brittle. It probably won't look exactly like that, but this is a very characteristic, very brittle failure, and glass would be a very typical material that showed that sort of behavior. Having mentioned thermally modified wood, what you'd probably see, obviously thermally modified wood doesn't have as high a modulus as glass, so if we were looking at thermally modified wood, we might see something like that. It might be quite linear. It might have a yield point or it might not. And when it failed, it might fail in a slightly more complicated way, so that rather than failing in one go, it would show this sort of failure. That's still quite a brittle failure. So that might be characteristic of a thermally modified timber, for example. So I'll say a little bit more about failure modes in a minute. I just need to clear this off. So if we have a brittle sample that shows hooking behavior, it will just go bang like that. This point here, that strain, would be known as the maximum elongation. So that's quite an easy thing to report. That's how much it got stretched before it broke. So that would be characteristic of a brittle sample, but if we have a sample that isn't brittle, like a piece of wood, we might get hooking behavior up to a point, then we reach the yield point and it begins to curve over. Then it gets to the point where it fails. So here we have the yield point. Here we've reached the ultimate tensile stress, which is higher than the yield point. So it's begun to fail, but being wood is a very tough material, and it tends to fail something like that. And with some specimens, or with composite materials, it might take a very long time to fail. And that's actually a very good thing from a design point of view, because brittle failure is not a good thing in materials that we want to use in structural applications. We'd much rather have modes of failure like this rather than modes of failure like that. And as I say, this is much more characteristic of a thermally modified timber, not a property you want to have in mechanical or in structural applications. So that's the maximum elongation. The ultimate tensile stress is there, so I've done that one, and that occurs, well, we haven't got a maximum, that's the problem. Where's the maximum elongation? The maximum elongation here is obvious. It's here, but where is it here with that sample? We haven't finished failing it yet, it's gone off the graph. It might do something like this, so you might get to a point where you can say, well, that's how far I stretched it before it completely failed. But it may or may not be a useful property to measure, but it will tell you something. If the maximum elongation occurs at the failure point, it will tell you it's a brittle material. If the maximum elongation doesn't occur at this failure point, then it's not brittle, it's a tough material, has a different mode of failure. So these mode of failures are very important. This linear, non-linear behavior is very important. Duration of loads, very important. Moisture content's important, temperature's important, previous history is important, and we haven't even talked about knots. These are for clear samples. So, complicated. I know what you're thinking. There's one missing, and it's not what you're thinking. Breaking stress. This is the ultimate tensile stress here, but there's one mode of failure I haven't shown. If the sample does this before it breaks, then the breaking stress, excuse the pen, is not the same as the ultimate tensile stress. So again, we have a different property, a different thing to report, which tells us something about the failure mode. So this has gone past any elastic plastic deformation, and we're, the sample's beginning to fail, but it hasn't broken yet. So this would be very characteristic of a polymer material, a thermoplastic polymer.